Hi, it's Katrina. Do you know how stars are named or how many stars there are in the sky? Here are 10 amazing things you probably didn't know about stars. Number 10, star classifications. Have you ever noticed that stars' names are kind of complicated? You may have seen sci-fi shows or movies where they give stars a category, but things are actually far more extreme. There are 11 different letter classifications, each that refer to a star's temperature, luminosity, and color. O and B type stars, for example, usually appear to be blue and are some of the hottest objects seen in the universe, ranging from between 20 and 40,000 Kelvin. That's more than 71,000 degrees Fahrenheit. On the other end of the spectrum are the K and M type stars. These ones are orange and red in color and are a comparatively cool 3,800 to 5,300 Kelvin, or around 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Stars are further categorized based on their speed of rotation and the type of elements that they contain, while the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram is a chart used to classify their color, with hydrogen-burning stars falling into the main sequence section of the chart, and stars in the advanced stages of their lives being placed elsewhere due to the colors formed when they fuse more complicated elements. Number 9. Stars don't twinkle. I know, sad but true, right? When you look up to the clear sky at night, you'll see a wide range of stars. Looking closely, you will probably even see some of them twinkling, but this apparent switching on and off of the light has nothing to do with the actual stars themselves. Instead, it's because of the Earth's atmosphere, and the effect is more noticeable the closer a star appears to the horizon. As the light passes through the layers of gas that make up the atmosphere, it reacts to the varying densities. Similar to the way a pinball bounces around a pinball machine, each layer deflects the light, which causes it to slightly change color and intensity, which results in it appearing to twinkle. This effect can be so pronounced that people mistake the stars for something else entirely. Sirius, for example, twinkles so much that it's the cause of numerous reports of UFO sightings every year. Number 8. How big do stars get? While our own star, the Sun, is a fairly common type throughout the galaxy, there are ones that absolutely dwarf it in terms of size and brightness. In fact, every single star that you see in the night sky is many times larger and brighter than the Sun, because it's only those that produce enough light to reach us. One of the largest stars that has ever been detected is called VY Canis Majoris. It's a red hypergiant star in the Canis Major constellation and is about 3,840 light-years from Earth. This star is simply huge. You could stack 1,420 of our suns on top of each other, and they would all still fit inside it, while its luminosity is more than 270,000 times that of the Sun. To put this into perspective, it would take a plane more than 1,000 years to fly around it, and if it was in the place of our Sun, it would extend beyond the orbital path of Saturn. Number 7. How many stars? How many stars do you think there are in the universe? The amazing thing is that no matter how huge a number you guess, there are probably far, far more out there. To understand how many there actually are, astronomers first calculate the estimated number of galaxies. With our current understanding, it's thought that there are about 170 billion galaxies in the observable universe, stretched out across 45.7 billion light-years. Of course, each galaxy has a different number of stars in it. Our own, the Milky Way, is home to around 400 billion, while some spiral galaxies hold a trillion, and some giant elliptical galaxies host as many as 100 trillion stars. If you add all the estimations together of all the galaxies, you reach a total number of stars that are theoretically observable of around 1 septillion stars. That's a 1 with 24 zeros after it. That's at least 1,000 times as many grains of sand that there are on Earth. Number 6. Red and blue. While many images that we see of stars in space have been created with a certain amount of artistic license, there's one thing for sure. Stars can be seen in a wide range of colors, but what we learn from these colors is somewhat counterintuitive. Two of the colors most often seen are red and blue. On Earth, we typically associate the color red with things that are hot, like a fire or a glowing hot piece of metal, and the color blue is more associated with things that are cold, like ice. This is completely the opposite when looking at stars, though, because they exist at much higher temperatures than we see on Earth. Heated objects change color as their temperature changes, and red actually represents the lowest temperature at which a heated object can glow in visible light. As things get hotter, they become white and then blue. This means that the red stars that you see are actually the coolest ones, and the blue ones are by far the hottest. Number 5. How close are stars? When you look at the sky, especially on a clear night, it seems like the stars are quite close to each other. Our grouping of them together into constellations also gives the impression that there's not a great distance between them. But this couldn't be further from reality. Apart from those that exist in the same systems as each other, such as binary stars, there are vast swaths of empty space in between each one. The nearest star to us, for example, is Proxima Centauri, and it's 4.24 light-years away from us, or about 25 trillion miles. Even if our fastest rockets, which travel at about 20,000 miles per hour, were to travel there, it would be a 150,000-year journey. Our Sun and its nearest neighbor are pretty normal in terms of proximity, which means that the vast majority of space is just that, empty regions of nothingness. It only seems like there's more there when you look into the sky because the universe is so large that you're seeing light from unimaginable distances away. Number 4. Star groups. Despite the vast distances between star systems, our Sun is actually unusual for the fact that it's on its own. Most stars actually tend to cluster together into groups of two or more. Bound by the gravitational forces, as many as 60% of stars remain in these groups. In the constellation of Orion, for example, three of the stars are bound together in what's known as the Mintaka cluster. In the constellation of Gemini, the Castor cluster has six stars together. The record for the number of stars found in one system currently stands at 7 and has been observed in two different places, both AR Cassiopeia, which is about 620 light-years from us, and Nu Scorpii, which is about 470 light-years away. There's not thought to be a maximum number that can exist together though, so it's quite possible that there are systems out there that have 10 or more. We just haven't found them yet. Number 3. Star brightness. Stars come in a variety of shapes and sizes, and brightness. The brightest star in our sky is, of course, our Sun, but it's pretty unremarkable in the grand scheme of things. The dimmest star to have ever been recorded is a brown star called RG0058.8-2807, in case anyone asks you. It is also the smallest star to have been detected, at only 0.014 times the size of our own Sun, and is 1 million times less bright. The brightest star, on the other hand, was seen at the end of April in 1006 AD, and is called SN1006. This star went supernova and was seen across the Earth, being recorded by observers in China, Japan, Egypt, and Europe. Reports said that it was visible even during the daytime, and the energy released by this event that took place about 7,200 light-years away was so significant that evidence of it has even been found in nitrate deposits in Antarctica. Number 2. The stars we see at night. We've already seen how there are about 1 septillion stars in the observable universe, but how many do you think are observable with the naked eye from Earth? If you look up on a clear night from a place with no light pollution, the entire sky is dotted with stars. But you're not seeing anywhere near as many as you might think. Every star that you see is bigger and brighter than our Sun because smaller, dimmer ones don't produce enough light to reach us. And in total, there are about 5,000 that are visible from Earth. Considering the fact that when you look up, you're only looking at half of the sky, this means that people with the most perfect eyesight, on a perfect night for viewing, will see a maximum of around 2,500 stars. One myth that you may have heard is that the stars you are looking at no longer exist because of the amount of time it takes for the light to reach us. While it's true that we're seeing the stars as they once were, it's actually more likely that they are still there, shining brightly. This is because the majority of the ones we can see are within 1,000 light-years of the Sun, and no more than 10,000 light-years away. Stars, of course, live much longer than 10,000 years, so it's highly unlikely that they have died already. Good news, right? Number 1. How long do stars live? The life expectancy of a star is directly related to its total mass, which indicates how much fuel it has to burn. Somewhat counterintuitively, those with the biggest mass die much quicker than those that start with less. This is because the bigger the mass of the star, the faster it burns its supply of fuel. The largest stars that exist can burn out and explode in a supernova within a few million years of beginning fusion. Smaller stars, such as our Sun, can continue burning for as long as 10 billion years, while even smaller stars can theoretically live for up to 100 billion years, which is longer than the entire universe has existed for. A star's mass also determines how it will ultimately die. The biggest ones will burn out quickly and explode into one of the brightest events in the galaxy, a core collapse supernova. Once the dust has settled, it will then collapse back into itself and form either a neutron star or a black hole. Stars that are a similar size to our Sun aren't quite as dramatic as this when they reach the end of their lives and swell up into red giants. The layers of these dying stars begin to shed, leaving behind a white dwarf star. White dwarfs themselves are believed to turn into black dwarfs, but this process would take such a long time that it may not have ever happened yet. Thanks for watching! Hope you learned something new today! Remember to subscribe before you leave, and I'll see you next time! Bye!